Welcome to 558 Parkside Tech, where we talk about tech's past, present, and future. My goal is to educate the culture. And as always, we strive for progress, not perfection. Today, we're going to talk about what it takes to be a developer in tech. And we're going to cover it in two flavors. One, for the developer who's brand new, who knows nothing about coding, who's just walking in, maybe they're taking a night class, or maybe they just want to learn tech because they're in school. The other flavor we're going to talk about is that developer who's been in a game for quite some time. Maybe that one that's coming from the IBM mainframe, who is doing DB2 or CICS or OSJCL. They've been doing it for quite some time. Because most people treat them like they're the walking dead. All right, let's talk about that. I'll see you at work right after this. 558 Parkside Tech in effect, 558 Parkside Tech in effect, 558 Parkside Tech in effect, Park, son. Now, if you're a new developer, there's a couple of things I would like for you to do. One is, if you haven't watched my object-oriented programming video, go back and watch that, because prior to writing code, you need to understand that we're dealing with objects. So understanding object-oriented programming, it's kind of important. Also, I want you to understand UML diagrams, so that if you had to put some ideas down, that you know how to diagram your ideas. You know how to put them down on paper for others to see it. And you need to understand what the fourth industrial revolution is all about. And that goes for any legacy developers, any older developers that have been around a while. You need to understand what the fourth industrial revolution is and get your arms around object-oriented programming. Now, after you go through that, then what I'd like for you to do is download a text editor. There are a few different ones, but I'm going to approach it from a C# perspective. I would like for you to download Visual Studio, but prior to that, look at the requirements for Visual Studio and make sure your computer can handle that's downloading that software. Make sure you have enough memory, make sure you have enough hard drive space. You might need a new computer, sorry. So I don't want you to try to download and it doesn't download and it doesn't go well. And you go, oh my God, what's wrong? You'll know right off the bat prior to, okay? Now, once you download Visual Studio, there may be a few flavors that you'll see. You'll see community, you'll see, I think it's the edition, you'll see the professional. Download anyone that's free. But really the community or the professional is fine. I know enterprising sounds sexy, the enterprise edition sounds sexy and that's what you think you need. But you're not ready to take that kind of robust system because inside the each edition adds more complexity. You just want enough just to be able to write code. And a text editor just helps you with syntax. If you don't know what the word syntax means, please look it up. It's just semicolons and commas and the structure of a language, all right? So that's for all new developers. That's the software we want to download, all right? Now, for legacy developers or newer developers, for older developers rather, what I'd like for you to do is this. I want you to, after you watch the object-oriented video and you go through it a few times, that you start thinking of all the paragraphs that you've written in your legacy applications. I want you to think of all your working storage, 88 levels, 01. Imagine if they were inside the paragraph, not outside in the data division or in the file section. I want you to think of it that way. And if you do, object-oriented programming will make perfect sense to you. Now, for those that want to know about databases, I've gotten some emails about, hey, when you start showing and explaining code, I want to know more about databases. Initially, I'm not going to cover databases in this part one or in part two. I think let's spend some time trying to get our arms around just writing code, just understanding the syntax of writing code in an object-oriented language. But I do want you to get familiar with a website called StackOverflow.com. I think it's StackOverflow.com. That's where most of your developers will go and where you will go in the future. Should you have questions on little things that you're doing, you can ask questions or there'll be examples that other developers have put out there. Another thing I would like for you to do is, I think there's a magazine called Computer World, computerworld.com. And you can have look at the online version of that and just see what's going on in tech. Surround yourself with tech always, okay? Now, as far as the future of tech, I'm going to cover that in part two. I think initially, just understanding object-oriented programming, understanding UML diagrams, getting familiar with just the overall structure of a text editor like Visual Studio. Now there's another one out there called VS Code. I don't want you to grab that one. I want you to use the one that if you had a job, you would be spending most of your time in, and that's Visual Studio. And again, whether that be the community version or the professional version, doesn't matter. Whatever you can download free and whatever your program can handle. Now, let me go into a little bit more about what we will do in part two. In part two, we're gonna go over your text editor that you've downloaded onto your computer. We're gonna walk through your computer. We're gonna actually write some code. We're gonna look at how to debug a program. Now, I want you to know, if you listen to some of my previous videos, I've said this. Program and application, we tend to use interchangeably in tech. Normally, multiple programs equal an application. For example, there are multiple programs that make up a banking application, but you could also have a one program application. So I'm going to be using those terms interchangeably. So we're going to be writing a console application. It's the simplest application you can write, and it's a good way to get your feet wet in tech. I know everybody wants to run. I hear people tell me all the time, hey, I want to learn programming, but I want to go the fast route. There is no fast route. You have to get the foundational things straight. If you don't get them straight, I'll tell you what'll happen. If you start copying code and you get a program working because you copied someone's code, it'll work, right? Makes sense. It'll work. You copied it because you saw it work. The problem is when it breaks, because you didn't understand how it was built and you didn't understand the concepts that were used to build it. When it breaks, you will spend most of your time trying to fix it and you'll be all over the place. I've been in many companies where we'll put something in production and it'll break. And then all of us will get on the phone. It'd be 20, 30, 40 people, people from security, networking, database, the developers that were part of developing it, and the application that connects to another application. We're all sitting on the phone for hours. Why? Because we never communicated. And some people who wrote what they wrote didn't really understand what they wrote. So when it broke, they didn't know how to fix it. We don't want to be in that boat. So getting these foundational understandings from part one and part two and part three and so forth is what you need, the foundation. Once we get the foundation, then we can take off running, which makes sense. Now, let me say this. Don't let me put flowers in the passenger seat, meaning you're not there. You're gone. No one's smarter than you. You can learn tech. You can learn how to code. And if you don't want to code, learning about coding will help you in any other positions that you take in tech. Never measure yourself against anybody else as you're learning either. There'll be people that are ahead of you, people that are behind you, but the goal really is to learn more today than you knew yesterday. And I hope each part of this series that you join me on, in this beginner series, that you walk away going, I didn't know that. Okay, that makes sense. And you feel like you're growing in tech. Is it an uphill battle? Yeah, for some. Because some concepts will make perfect sense to you, and then some concepts, you're gonna have to watch the video over and over again, or you're probably gonna shoot me an email, which is cool. Just stay after it. Consistency is the key. No one's smarter than you. You can do it. So stay after it, all right? Well, thank you for joining me. And if you're on YouTube, please hit the like button. Or hit subscribe so that you can get all the new videos that are being released. And as always, be greater than your greatest excuse and learn tech, because the culture really needs to be in this space. That's all I got. Peace. And now this, no cap. 58 part site tech in effect. Tap in the future. Let me introduce you. 558 Parks I Tech, about to school you. 558 Parks I Tech, in effect. 558 Parks I Tech, in effect. 558 Parks I Tech, in effect. Park, 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 son.